I just finished another training with about 50 therapists from Texas, and I want to share some more of my thoughts about what came clear for me while I was doing this. I wanted to share with you a couple of concepts. One I talked about a couple of weeks ago, which is called flattening the curve on anxiety or bending the curve of anxiety. And I wanted to share this with you because now I have a picture that I can show you. And I just posted that a few minutes ago. But the idea here is that we've been talking so much about bending the curve on COVID-19 that people understand this concept about how important it is to keep whatever we're dealing with below our capacity to cope so that when it overwhelms us, we're able to deal with it and manage it without turning into a place of we end up feeling out of control, being out of control, doing out of control things. So if you haven't seen that, just notice it. But the good part of this thing is that it's pretty straightforward. If you think about that, anxiety is a natural thing that we all experience. It's an experience we have in our body that says, oh, something's going on. I need to pay attention. And then it's a call to action in our body. And this comes from our learned experience, from what we have concluded through years of experiences that teach us that in this condition, I need to do this thing to stay safe, whether it's fight or flight or freeze or faint or, just collapse. We've conditioned ourselves to respond to these triggers that are all around us. And in most cases, we don't end up finding ourselves out of control. We notice the anxiety and we start to pay attention to it. And that's all you have to do to bring this curve down and to keep it manageable is to recognize what your triggers are. And as you approach them, be able to keep breathing, to be able to observe what's going on, to be able to think clearly in the top of your brain about what's happening. Is this a real threat? Is this a felt threat? Is this a trigger into the past or fear about the future? If you can recognize that, you can immediately take some action to calm that anxiety in your body, whether that's just breathing or whether that's tapping, thought field therapy, or whether that's kicking into some meditative state that works for you, or whether that's avoiding it, whether that's reaching out for more resources. There are lots of things we can do so that that anxiety of a real threat or a trigger can be kept below our capacity to be overwhelmed, our capacity to cope. Now, it's important to do that because if you don't do that, what happens is then the body takes over and our reaction takes over. And it's no longer a planned response to what we need to do that's in our best interest, but it's just reacting. And then we're over into that place where the body feels panic. It's not just a matter of I feel a little uncomfortable. I feel like I have to take action or I will die. Our mind, instead of being able to step back and look at what's going on and to put it into some kind of formulation that helps us be able to think and plan, what happens in our mind is we just get a piece of information and it just spins over and over and over. It's that OCD kind of stuff that goes on. And when our mind's in that state, we are not in the best place to make decisions about how to proceed, what actions to take. Oftentimes when we exceed that capacity to cope, suddenly our connectedness, in a sense of being connected spiritually to ourselves or other resources or to other entities, however you think about these things, goes away also. And once that connection is lost, we're alone. That and in that alone place, it's just going to make us feel again, we have to react. We can't really take time to think and plan and respond in a way that's going to serve us and those that we love the best. So this is the idea. You don't want to get to the place where your feelings are out of control and your behavior is out of control. You want to stay in that place where you feel in control and your behaviors are in control. If you can do that, then you know what? Life's a lot easier. And we've been talking about, you know, bending the curve on COVID-19. And the way you do that is just apply the things that work the best. And if you've been dealing with anxiety, or you work with clients — I'm a therapist — you work with clients who have anxiety, you over the time have found things that work for each individual better than others. And you just have to remember to know the triggers, and also recognize the symptoms in your body when you're getting into that place where that anxiety is starting to build and you're finding yourself not making your best decisions or taking your best action. So I think that this stuff is really helpful as a way to visualize and to think about what you're trying to do. You don't have to get rid of anxiety. Anxiety is something that is normal and is there for all of us. So, you know, if you're watching this and you think these ideas are useful to you, or you can send them on to somebody else, please do that. Give me a like to let me know what you think of this, or a comment. Also, feel free to tag this off and send it to other people who you think will find some use in thinking about it in this way, and remembering that you do have some control, and that if we can bend the curve on this anxiety, that we're not going to get to that out of control place. It's very important that once you find something that works, that you continue to do those things. Right now, COVID-19, we have some things that are working to help us cope with it. And I just wanted to share with you a bit of a John Oliver. I saw it on his program. He talks about Ruth Bader Ginsburg has a quote that is completely applicable to what we're doing as we think about when is it time to stop applying the measures that are working. So the way I paraphrase it is that throwing out social distancing, staying at home, wearing a mask, hand washing, when it has worked and is continuing to work to stop the spread and death of COVID-19, is like throwing away your umbrella in a rainstorm because you are not getting wet. So many people are reaping the benefits of the social isolation, of following these rules. And we don't even know it because this umbrella is covering us so well. But let's keep the umbrella up. Let's try to keep ourselves going in a way that we're doing what's right for ourselves, for the people we love, for the community that we're part of. This is one of those responsibilities that we have. And even though it's more difficult for some people than others, and it is more difficult for some than others, we have to keep in place what is working for us to curve, flatten the curve of COVID-19, to stay within a coping range for our health systems, and also just apply this to your own life, to flatten the curve on the anxiety that you feel by applying those things you found that are useful. And in the same way that we need to you know, measure our exposure to a disease, we need to measure our exposure to those things that trigger us into anxious states. Anyway, if you're interested in more about this, or the best way I know to curve this anxiety is through thought field therapy, because it immediately takes us to a place where we can cope. I usually tap with people, but I'm going to tell you, just go to my website, www.rlbray.com, and click the button that says try TFT, and scroll through the video of me tapping and try it and see if that doesn't help you curve your anxiety to a level that keeps it within your capacity to cope and to think and to plan and to act in ways that bring joy to yourself and those you love. Anyway, please feel free to write me an email, rlbray@rlbray.com, or, you know, you can always message me through Facebook. So good luck to you. I hope you, this is Friday for me. I hope you guys all have a nice weekend, and let me know if there's anything I can do to help. Bye-bye.